The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 21, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 15th, 1973, in Bombay, India.
Nature is said to be the cause of all material activities and effects, whereas the living entity is the cause of the various sufferings and enjoyments in this world.
This is very funny that you get the body according to your karma. But you are liable to enjoy or suffering according to the body. The body is given by the nature. In another place it is confirmed. Brahman sarvahutani jantra rurani maya. The living entity, just like we on this jeep car, we can move from here and there. Somebody has given me the car and for movement. Similarly, we are getting a jantra, a moving instrument, this body with senses, different bodies. So I am seated there, but the movement is not in my direction. That is my nature's own way. Prakritakrimana, in another place it is confirmed. Prakritakrimana ni guni karmani sarva. Ahamkar vimuratma kattaham iti mannati. This is our foolishness. So long we are under the clutches of Maya, it is just like pulling by the ear. Come here, sit down, like that. Prakritakrimana ni. But the illusory Maya, by the influence of illusory Maya, the living entity thinks that I am doing this, I am doing that. Everything is controlled. The ultimate controller is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Because Ishvara Sarvabhutana Vriddhesho Arjuna Tishtati Brahmaya in the present, he is causing to move or wander. Sarvabhutani, all living entities under different conditions of the body. So, how much foolish we are that we are getting a particular type of body and a sukha-dukha, happiness, and this stage is already fixed up. That is called destiny. As soon as I get a particular type of body, my happiness and sufferings are all destined. This is our position. So, we are trying to make the situation improve. Because after all, as soon as you get this material body, it is suffering. There is no question of happiness. But by the illusory energy, by illusion, you are thinking you are enjoying. That is called illusion, Maya. Just like the same example, a hog is eating stew. But he is thinking, he is enjoying. This is called prakhyapātmikāsukti. Not only hog, even in human society, somebody eats the most abominable, most rotten fish, Still he is thinking, he is enjoying. He has seen it. Unless he thinks like that, how? If he thinks that this is the most rotten thing, then he cannot leave. The Maya must make him forget that he is eating the most rotten thing. He thinks it is very nice. Maya vritam jnana. So this is the consequence of our forgetfulness. There are varieties of living entities, bodies. Rantandas Thakur therefore said, karmakanda jnanakanda sakali visare bhanda amrita boliya jeva khar nana jani bhraman kare kadarja bhakhan kare tara janma adhap pade. Nanajani Brahman kar. We are wondering in different species of life. There are cockroaches in the commode. They are also thinking. I mean, a tree standing for 7,000 some years. And he is also thinking, I'm enjoying life. So this is going on. And we are not very much serious about this thing, that I am part and parcel of God, Satchidananda Vigraha. I am Najayatanam Vriyate. My position is that I never take my birth and never die. Nahannate Hannamare Sarire. I do not die even after the destruction of this body. These things are my privileges, but I do not wish to take care of them. This is called Maya. You are satisfied in this abominable condition of life by a body given by the nature. If we suffer or enjoy, no enjoyment, everything is suffering according to the body, and the body is supplied by the nature. That is explained here. Sarja karana kartitte hetu prakriti ruchyate. Kartitte, but my action, that is also directed by the material nature. Originally directed by Ishvara, who is sitting within your heart. Sarvasya chaham ridhisanni vishta matta smriti jnanam apohananch. But it is being acted through the agency of material nature. Kārya kārana kocchitte hetu prakriti ruchyate. Prakriti. Just like one criminal is punished by the magistrate that this man should undergo 6 months imprisonment. So the judge or the magistrate superficially is the cause of his punishment, but actually he is not. He is giving him punishment according to law. I have created such a situation. I have made myself a criminal, and the magistrate according to law giving me punishment. Actually, directly, the magistrate is not the cause of my suffering. Why he should be caused? He is not your enemy. This is why. Kārya kārana kartitte hetu prakriti ruchyate. Purusha sukha dukkhana bhoktitte hetu ruchyate. So, bhoktitta, my enjoyment, because we have come to this material world for enjoyment. So everyone's enjoyment is not of the same standard. We can see that. Somebody is enjoying some way, another is enjoying. One man's food, another man's poison. What is enjoyed by the home is not enjoyed by other animals. This is the end. Therefore, when you get real consciousness, by good association. If we can understand that I am under the clutches of Maya, Prakriti, and I am dictated according to my association with the quality of the nature, and I am getting different types of body, different types of situation for my distress or happiness, this is my position, nonetheless fully under the control of the Prakriti. It cannot be changed. Devijesa gunamai mama maya durasthaya. Not possible. Devijesa gunamai mama maya durasthaya. You cannot change. But you can change by one process. What is that? Mami vajap prapadvanti mayami tāntara. If you surrender to Krishna, then you can get out of this control of maya. Otherwise it is not. Māmi vajap prapadyante, māyāmi tāṁ tarante. Then what should be our decision? The better not to try for improving our material condition of life. That cannot be changed. It is not possible. According to destiny, we have to enjoy our suffering. This is called adrishta. Therefore, the śāstra gives you advice. Tasyaiva heto prajapeta kovido nalambhati jan pamadāmu parido. Tallambhati dukkha valam natas sukham kalena sarvatra gavira namas. Śāstra said, don't easily try to improve your position. The modern economists, they will say, no, we are not going to accept this. Well, it is a fact. People are trying to improve the condition of the poor man. But it is going on. But there are thousands and millions of poor men. 50 years ago, when I first came to Bombay, at that time I was grihastha. I saw there are persons lying down care of footpath. And 50 years after, we are seeing the same thing going on. No change. There is a class of men who must lie down care of footpath. There are so many institutions, Daridranarayana Seva. Well, why there are dharidras still? That means you cannot change. It is not possible. It is not possible. Just like a man who has done something criminal and is in prison. Can you take him out? It will be another criminal action. If you try to take him away from the prison house by some means, then he will be punished and he will be punished, both. This is the law of state. Similarly, how you can surpass the stringent laws of nature and the laws of God? That is not possible. That is Vedic civilization. They were not very much anxious to improve material position. Even at the present moment, you go to the village, the innocent villagers, they are satisfied with the position Krishna has given, but they are anxious to improve their spiritual life. That is still, you'll find. Of course, it is not that you will not try to earn your livelihood, that you want, but you should not endeavor or give more time for your so-called material improvement. Better save time and utilize that time for improving your Krishna consciousness. That is purpose. That is the injunction of the śāstra. Tasyaiva heta prajapeta kovido. Now shall I not try for my happiness? That if you try, where is your happiness? he can get so much degree of happiness as what is tea, not more than that. So why should you waste your time? No, I see so many people have improved. So the answer is that tallabhati dukkha vadannata sukham. It is very nice news. Dukkha vadannata sukham. They say nobody tries for unhappiness. But why unhappiness comes? I do not want something, unhappiness. But it is forced upon me. That means destiny. I must have it. You are very nice man, you are doing nicely, but some disgrace is enforced upon you by force. That is our experience. So, the reason is, logic is given, that even without trying for distress, if distress is enforced upon me, so similarly, if I am destined to enjoy something, that will be also enforced upon me. So why should I waste my time? This so-called happiness. This trying for happiness, I have tried many lives. Fortunately, I have got this human form. What is our trap? We try for eating, sleeping, mating, and defense. So that is available by the laws of nature. Even a bird, beast, he has got arrangement. Birds, when they take birth, there are two birds, one male and female. The sex arrangement is already, and because they have no marriage, I would say, problem. They eat from 3 to 3, there is fruit. They sleep also, they have their sex life. And when there is danger, they try to defend. Everyone. If you also try to improve, but that cannot be improved. So now we have got higher consciousness, developed consciousness. We should try to understand the problems of life. Adhartam brahma jigyasa. This human form of life is meant for inquiring about the absolute truth, the supreme soul. Atmatattva jigyasa. Therefore Bhagavad says, parabhavastha abodhajata javanna jigyasataya atmatattam. Parabhavastha abodhajata. Everyone is born rascal and poor. Unless one is rascal and fool, one does not take birth in this material body. One who is actually in knowledge, he becomes liberated. Jnana vairagya yuktaya. That is the result of knowledge. If you are not liberated, if you have not stopped our reputation of birth and death, that means we are in ignorance. Therefore, Sartre says, the saiva hita prajati hita kovida. Kovida means very intelligent person. Expert. Bhavanam jarvanam ante jnanavan maam pravatati. These are the signs, symptoms of knowledge, wiseness. And another place, Bhagavad says, parabhavastavat abodhajata. Everyone is born fools and rascals and is acting in foolishness and rascaldom. Therefore, whatever he is doing, this is his defeat. This is his defeat. Actually, if we think very cool-headed, suppose whole life I have earned so much money, bank balance, skyscraper building, everything. But if my next life I become a cat or dog or rat, there is possibility. Because if I am not destined to enjoy, because this life I committed so many sinful activities, I am not going to have very comfortable life. But I have got attraction for my building which I have constructed with so many efforts. So nature is allowed to live in that building again next life, maybe as a cat, dog or a rat. Tathādehāntara prāpti, you do not know what kind of body you are going to. You completely under the stringent laws of nature. Here it is said, kārya-kārana-tattitte-hetu-prakiti-ucchate. As soon as you give up this body, you are completely under the greed of material nature. And you will get a type of body according to your karma. And then, purusa-sukha-dukkhānam-bhokti-tte-hetu-ucchate. The purusa, the living entity, will have to enjoy or suffer according to that body. So this is the science of Bhagavad Gita. One has to learn these things, otherwise he is spoiling his human life. One must know that what is the importance of this human form of life. One must take to Krishna consciousness to save himself. Try to understand Krishna only, then you are saved. Janma karma medibam yujanati tattva. Taktadriham punar janma naiti. The problem is janma mitta jarabhyadi dukkha dosana. This problem we have set aside. We are busy for a few years' life, 50 years, 20 years, we have forgotten that we are eternal. We don't die after the destruction of this body. Rānnate hannamāne sarī. This is my problem. What kind of body again I am going to get? Therefore, parābhavastāva. Javanna jigyāsata ātma-tattvam. So long we do not inquire about the ātma-tattvam. So whatever we are doing, it is all foolishness and defeat. It is actually defeat. We got an opportunity, this human form of life, to get out of this control of material nature, get completely freedom. If we don't try for that, simply if we try like cats and dogs, how to improve the method of eating, sleeping, sex life and living, we are spoiling our life. This is the instruction of our world. Thank you very much.